You are watching the Mulders World Report. I'm Ro, and he's Sean. We're from MuldersWorld.com. Thank you for tuning in. Today, what do we have, Sean?
Well, we have this alien. Another, I love aliens, you know. Yeah, there's a lot of things on this planet that look alien. Being called an alien, too. This one is a 10-foot barbed worm, is what they call it.
Okay, let's take a look. This thing is gross. Now, this thing looks like an alien monster to me for sure. I mean, I have no problem with people saying, look at this alien. That's exactly what it looks like to me. I don't know.
It just looks nasty. I thought it was Photoshop when I first saw it, but you're telling me this is a real thing. And then so I looked up barbed worm, right? Because that's a scientific name that someone was using.
Yeah, I think it's called the Unis Aphroditos or something Latin, something crazy.
Yeah.
But this is not Photoshop. That is a massive 10-foot worm that you are looking at. This thing is a monster. It is gross, it's big, and it's actually fairly ferocious from what I understand.
You know, when you look at, there's a picture of it underwater. It looks, you know, pretty beautiful, but
yeah,
when it comes out, when it surfaces, it's as ugly, nasty as it's thin.
Fucking nasty. All right, here's a little fact. A public aquarium had accidentally or unknowingly shipped in some sand and coral, and they had no idea that they had shipped in this bobbit worm. So they had their fish go missing and ending up dead, and they couldn't figure out. So this beautiful public aquarium, one day they see this thing come out, and there is a 10-foot ferocious worm decimating all these rare and beautiful fish in this public aquarium. And it's a difficult thing to deal with because it burrows itself into the sand. And they had to get it out there because it was eating everything. These things are mean. They are as nasty as they look. So I don't want to run into one of those.
Well, yeah, I mean, underwater they have this rainbow type of color, you know, underneath its belly, and it actually looks pretty nice. Yeah. I don't know if you can pull that up, bro, but
I'm gonna see if I can pull it up right now. You guys hang tight. So it
actually pokes its head out up from the sand. And I guess that's how he catches the fish.
And this, to me, is until we have like proof of alien life in our midst, this is an alien. This is, to me, I have no problem calling this thing an alien. Let me see if I can find this other picture that you're talking about.
It does kind of remind you of the Starship Troopers. You know how they got those alien things that pop up in the sand and just like grab you and then pull you in. It looks like that. I mean, imagine you were a fish, right? You're just swimming along, little fish. All of a sudden, this thing just comes up and just grabs you like a hand and pulls you under.
It's like, man. Look at this pretty little rainbow. I'm a nice little thing. You don't realize that there's 10 feet of slimy worm underneath the sand there, and it's ready to spring up and chomp on you. So there it is. That is called the bobbit worm. You can find more about the bobbit worm on MuldersWorld.com. Just go there, hit your little search button, and type in worm and take a look for yourself. It is a fascinating little alien. This is a real-life alien, folks. This is as strange and foreign as it gets. I'm Ro. He's Sean. We will see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for tuning in.
Thanks.
We'll be right back.